Good morning, everybody. So I work in a TIMA laboratory, which in a micro and nano system group, and I work in Grenoble, in France. It's not easy to pronounce. And I am going to speak about microsensor for instrumented medical tools for their real-time monitoring. So I began my talk by explaining the context of the project, the previous works we have done, and how we do the microfabrication of the microsensors and their first experimentations, and after how we improve the gauge factor of our microsensors, and how we integrate the connection, and I end by conclusion and perspectives. So our project is in the interventional radiology, and when a physician must be a must do a punction or biopsy, he must insert in the body a very long and thin needle. This needle can bend, and if it bends, it don't reach the target. So sometimes or many times, a physician use imaging to help him. And the imaging, we have here ultrasound imaging. And if you, you use in ultrasound imaging, you have not a very clear image. And it's difficult to see all the scene of the BOC, for example. So when the physician inserts his needle, he thinks it not bent and reach its target, but he's not sure. So if it bent, we don't know what he do. He can also use, for example, X-ray imaging, but X-ray is dangerous also for the patient, but for the medical people. And he not use many times. And he can use also MRI, but MRI is not available every time, and it's also expensive. So in this project, we propose to put microsensor directly on the needle to give in real time the deformations of the needle during its use. So our previous works, we begin to use a big needle, an interventional radiology needle, which is 20 centimeters long and 1.8 millimeters in diameter. And we glued commercially micro gauges on the needle at three positions. Each position. So here, three positions, and between each position, excuse me, there is 120 degrees. The commercially micro gauges are 2 millimeters long and one millimeter width. And we after experiment. So for the experimentation, we clamp the end of the needle, and we make at the tip of the needle some trajectories like this one. We make two circles. The first one have a radius of 3 millimeters and the other a radius of 6 millimeters. And we made straight diameter. At each black point, we make measure. It allow us to know if on two different trajectories, circle and straight diameter, for example, if we have at this point, for example, the same measure. So we can, after the measure, plot the different results of each gauge. This one is the third one, and we show here that the one is more close. Where is my? So the Gojuan is closer than the clamping, so he measures the most deformation, the most important deformations, and the other one less one, and etc. And we can also, with calculation, determine the real value that the gauge must measure, and it shows that we have a good correspondence with the theory and experimentation. So we have shown with this work the feasibility of our project. So after, we want to have micro-gauges more smaller than the commercially one, and we want to put them on more thin needles, because more the needle is big and more is invasive for the patient. So we, to make microfabrication, we work on substrate like this one, called wafer. The wafer was in silicone or glass. The wafer has a diameter of 4 inch, and we want to work on a medical needle which have a diameter of 0.6 millimeter and a length of 10 centimeters. So we can't use microfabrications easily. We have for use classical machine in clean room, design a support, and this support is shown here. It has the same diameter than the wafer, but is in stainless steel, because the needles, the medical needles, are in stainless steel, and when we must heat all of the support, we need to have the same deformations of all of the support and needles. So we make in the support grooves by electro-discharge machining, and we insert our needles in the grooves, and the upper of the needle is out of the support, and it is on this part of the needle that we are going to fabricate our microsensor. So this part is 400 micrometer width. So here is the cut of the support with the little grooves. So now I present the microfabrication process. It began with a sputtering of silicon nitride, which is an insulator layer. And the silicon nitride is about 200 nanometer. After, we put by evaporation a layer of germanium for 400 nanometer with a little layer of gold of 20 nanometer. The germanium is our microsensor, and the gold is used for the crystallization of the germanium. When we put germanium, the germanium is amorphous, and we need to have a good piezo-resistive characteristics of germanium to crystallize it by annealing. And to crystallize germanium, we must heat upper than 600 degrees. But our needle is in stainless steel, and we can't go up to 340 degrees. So to stay under this temperature, we put a little layer of gold to have crystallization annealing under 350 degrees. So after, we make the annealing 2 hours at 300 degrees. After that, we can etch the gold layer and put another gold layer by evaporation. It's a chromium gold because chromium it's adherence layer, and after gold it's used to connect our microsensor, so we can make the wire bonding. You can show here our first microfabrication. It's not it's difficult to take photos because we must gross the microsensor, and because of the surface is curved, we have not we can't focalize everywhere. So here is the needle with the pink color is a silicon nitride. The gray layer here is a germanium layer, which is the microsensor, and the two pads in gold to make after wire bonding. The dimension is shown here. The length is 500 micrometer, and the width of each part here is 50 micrometers. So after, we can make the here wire bonding. Here is at the end of the fabrication. So we have our support with the different needles, and on each needle we have fabricated 5 microsensors. We see each here, and we can see that sometimes in the last one, you can see between the two pads there is a little gold stay, because it's difficult to remove gold between the two pads, because there is only 50 micrometers. We do that by lift off, but it's very little long to explain, and I can't explain here, but if you want, I can say you how we have this problem. So after, we experiment this first realization, and like in a previous experimentation, we clamp the needle near the micro gauge, and we put the tip of the needle in this red piece, which is screwed on a micrometric micrometric table, and we have here the instrumentation electronic card, which allow to measure the results of the microsensor, and we use a LabVIEW interface to acquire the measure. So after, we can draw, for example, is here a straight trajectory, and we repeat the same trajectory to see if we have same results, and it's the case here. Also, one point is not on the straight. So after, with some calculation by some equation, we find a gauge factor of 3. We can compare with the commercialized gauges, which have a gauge factor of 2. Is not very satisfactory. So we can improve this gauge factor. And to improve this gauge factor, we must work on the material aspect of the germanium, because the gauge factor is directly linked to the piezoresistive characteristic of the germanium layer. So we must study the crystallization annealing, and this annealing has 3 important parameters. First one, the temperature, but we don't want to change the temperature because we don't go upper 300 degrees, but we can change the duration or the thickness of the metal layer. So we have used 20 nanometers of gold to make our crystallization. We find this in the literature, and we are not sure after our experimentation. So we make X-ray diffractometry to verify if it's the good thickness of the layer to make so the MIC is a metal induced crystallization. So we show with X-ray diffractometry that we must have 40 nanometer, not 20, to have a good crystallization at 300 degrees. So here are the results of the diffractometry. So here, 20 nanometers of gold and 400 nanometer of germanium. We put that on silicon to be easy. It's more easy for us to make echantillon. And here we don't see very well the green curve, but we can see the pink one and the red one. And the pink peaks here are the germanium peaks, and we can see that at 300 degrees we have no crystallization, and it began at 325, and we can see also here. Degrees, we have a little peak. It's the beginning of the crystallization of the germanium. Sometimes it. So after, we can show if you continue to grow the temperature. So we have yes, here at 350 degrees. We see that we have a good crystallization, and if we continue, we can see growing. Here is a 40 nanometers layer of gold with 400 nanometers of germanium, always on silicon. And we can see at 200 degrees, here are the peaks, the germanium peaks. And we can see that at 200 degrees, we begin the crystallization. So we can look after upper than 300 degrees. We have a very good crystallization.
I'm going to switch it for you.
Here, and the three peaks are very clear.
There you go.
Thank you. Here, if we have a temperature at 600 degrees, and after, if we return at ambient temperature, we show in green here the germanium peaks. So, to integrate the connection, I have shown that in the first fabrication, we make pads just near the microsensor, but it's not possible to introduce this sort of needle in the tissues because of the connection can stay. So we want to make the connection of the microsensor at the end of the needle. So here it's a shame of the needle, and if we zoom, we show here the two microsensors, and if I zoom, I see here the microsensor with tracks to go at the end of the needle to can make our connection at the end of the needle and can insert them in the human tissues. So we have adapted the microfabrication to have a better gauge factor. We have modified the crystallization annealing parameters. We now do not the gold etching that I have shown in the first microfabrication, because this etching avoid damage in the on certain microsensor. And we have shown that if we don't etch gold, we do not change the resistivity of the germanium. So yeah, it has always good parameters. And we don't make connecting pads, but smaller connecting tracks. So there is the result of our last microfabrication last month. So we have always the pink color of the silicon nitride, the gray of the germanium. We can see a little dust here. And in yellow, we have the connecting pads. So here is one microsensor with connecting tracks, but we don't see very well because of the focalization of the microscope. So sometimes you can see here the microsensor, and here is the gold layer not removed by liftoff. It's sometimes very difficult to remove it. Sometimes it not removed, but removed after, and here too. So we manually remove this layer because it is not there is no adhesion between this layer and the needle, but it don't remove easily. So in conclusion, the experimentation of the new macro-ecogies with their connection at the extremity of the needle are in progress. We always use bonding, which is very fragile, but bonding at the end of the needle. We want now to put three micro-ecogies at 120 degrees with their connection at the extremity of the needle. I'll show you after a shim. We design actually in parallel a connector to get free to the bonding because it's fragility. And the next goal will be to fabricate a prototype that we can integrate in a micro-localization system to test it. So here we have a prototype that we want to fabricate. We have a zoom, and here we want to have three microsensors with 120 degrees between each and the connecting tracks to put at the end the micro connector which we are actually designing. We have shown in this work that it's possible to instrument a medical tool to monitor it. And we have opened a dent in the field of microfabrications applied to medical instruments with unconventional shape and material. Because, as I say at the beginning, the material classically used in clean room is silicone and wafer. And we use needles which are in stainless steel and with curved surface. So we can expect it now the development of the instrumentation of other medical tools. I want to thank my students, PhD and trainee, and the ANR, Agence Nationale de la Recherche in France, for the funding of this project. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Dr. Agnes, on your talk on microfabrication. It's got a lot of application in biomims. Now the topic is open to the floor for discussion.
Yes?
So I'm doing paper work, but my colleagues do. Just neither here nor there. I'm really curious about the gold germanium interface. I don't think I've seen that before. And how do you get the two? You said the germanium crystallizes gold. I wasn't clear on how you get the interface, the germanium gold interface. interface?
There is the interface is natural. We use evaporation. It's a machine which evaporates the material by I don't know how to say. It's we liquefy gold in a little cup, and it was vaporized. And
it's not sputtering.
Okay. It's evaporation. It's another technique.
How do you get it to form that those prongs like that?
The wire bonding. What do you?
It sort of formed this sort of. Is there a template? You, I don't understand how you did that.
I am not sure I understand you. The U shape is a microsensor. It's a germanium U shape. It's a macro gauge. You can measure all deformations when you put a micro gauge somewhere. And the two gold pads allow us to connect the micro gauge. To make because we put electrical current to pass through the microsensor, and we can measure the difference of the resistance of the germanium and determine the bending of the needle.
Is the germanium put down also in liquid form and evaporated?
Yes, is by the same technique.
Do we have any more questions from the floor? Otherwise, let's applause Dr. Agnes for a nice talk on